Good morning, children. Hope you all are doing fine. Okay, you are studying also, na? Very good, children. Now, hardly 3 months are done. Study well, and then go to the next class. Now, today I am going to teach you maths. In that, I am going to teach you direct proportion and inverse proportion. Let's start.
D I R E C T, direct proportion. P R O P O R A T I O N.
Okay. Now, what is this direct proportion? Suppose I purchase 5 pens. Okay, what I did? 5 pens. Now, this cost of five pens is 50 rupees. Okay, this is the pens. This is rupees. Cost of 5 pens is 50 rupees. Now, if I want to purchase 10 pens, now the rate will increase or decrease? Obviously, it will increase, isn't it? Why? Because the quantity is increased. 5 pens is increased to 10. So, obviously, this will also get increased. Okay? When there is an increase in quantity, there is an increase in price also. Okay? So, it is a direct proportion. Okay? In direct proportion, if there is an increase, okay, then there will be an increase in the other commodity also. Okay, here 5 pence 50 rupees. 10 pence will be how much? 10 pence will be how much? 5 pence 50 rupees. So 50 divided by 5 is equal to 5 1 jar, 5 10 jar. So, cost of 1 pen, okay, cost of 1 pen is equal to 10 rupees. So, cost of 10 pen will be, 10 pence will be equal to 10 into 10 is equal to 100 rupees. So, cost of 10 pen is equal to 100 rupees. When the quantity increased, the price also increased. So, this is unitary form of method which you have studied in your 6th standard. How to check the rate of one commodity and then multiply with the increased commodity. Cost of 5 pence, 50 rupees. Cost of 10 pence, 100 rupees. For finding this, first we found the cost of 1 pen and then we found the cost of 10 pen. Got it? Now, we will see the direct proportion method which is related to our 7th standard syllabus. Okay. So, in simple terms, direct proportion means if there is an increase in one product or commodity, there will be an increase with the other. So, it will be in same direction. Got it? Now, next, what we are going to do? Another sum. Suppose I purchased 7 kg of onion at 140 rupees. Okay. I purchased 7 kg of onion at 140 rupees. What will be the cost of 12 kg of onions? Okay. What I did? See. I will make a box. I am purchasing what? Onions. Kg. 7 kg, how much rupees? 140 rupees. For 12 kg, I don't know. So, I have taken x. Okay? So, what will be there? 7 upon, how you will solve? 7 upon 12 is equal to 1 upon 40. First, when you saw 7 kg, 140 rupees, 12 kg will, obviously, the rate will increase. So, it is a direct proportion. Okay. When there is an increase in the quantity, there will be an increase in the price. Okay. So, it is what? Direct proportion. For direct proportion, you will write as it is 7 upon 12, 140 upon x. Then, cross multiply. Okay. 7 into x, 7x is equal to 12 into 140. Okay, did cross multiplication. Then, this I am writing here again. 7x is equal to 12 into 140. Now, what is here? Multiplication. I have taught you that now. What is opposite of multiplication? Division. So, what I will do? 7x upon 7. Here, 7 is multiplied to x. I will take division. Okay? Is equal to 12 into 140 upon 7. So, what I am doing in LHS, the same thing I will repeat in RHS also. So, 7, 7 cancel. X is remaining. This 7, 1s are 7, 2s are 140. 7, 2s are 14. And this 0 I will put as it is. Okay? Children, if you have doubt in cancellation, what you can do? Directly you can go for 7, 140 and divide it and see. Okay? You will get the answer as 20 only. Then, what is remaining? 12 into 20. So, x is equal to 12, 2s are 24. So, what is this x? Mr. X call him. He is the 12 kg onions rate. Okay? So, the answer is cost of 12 kg of onions is equal to rupees 240. Got it? What I did? First, I have made a box kg and rupees, and then 7 kg 140 rupees, 12 kg I don't know. Then we have written as it is because it is direct proportion. 7 upon 12 is equal to 140 upon x. Then other calculation as per we were doing regularly. Okay. That is cross multiplication. 7x is equal to 12 into 140. Here it is division. Sorry, multiplication. So opposite of multiplication, division. So 7x upon 7. 12 into 140 upon 7. You cancelled it and you got the answer as 240. Got it? I will give you one more sum. Fine? Of direct proportion. It's very easy. Don't confuse. Only simple thing is that when there is an increase in certain rate, obviously there will be an increase in the other rate also. Now suppose I am going to purchase mobiles. Okay? Now this is number of mobiles. Suppose I purchased 10 mobiles at the rate of 40,000. Okay? I am purchasing 10 mobiles at the rate of 40,000. What will be the rate of 5 mobiles? Okay? I am purchasing 10 mobiles at the rate of 40,000. What will be the rate of 5 mobiles? Same. 10 mobiles, rate is, the quantity is decreased. So, obviously, the rate will increase or decrease. The rate will also decrease. So, what is this? Same direction. Okay. When there is increase or decrease in the same direction, then it is direct proportion. Okay. Here, quantity is decreased, rate will also decrease. So, it is direct proportion. Understand properly. Now, we will solve. What 10 upon 5 is equal to 40,000 upon x. This is direct proportion. Cross multiplication. 10x upon 5. Sorry, 10x is equal to 40,000 into 5. Got it? 10 into x, 5 into 40,000. Now 10x, here it is multiplication. What I will do? Divide. 10x upon 10 is equal to 40,000 multiplied by 5 upon 10. 0, 0 cancel. Here also 0, 0 cancel. Now the answer is 4, 5s are 20. What I did? 4, 5s are 20. Now how many zeros are there? 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Okay. What I did? 4 into 5, 20. Then 1, 2, 3. 3 zeros are 100. So cost of 5 mobiles will be equal to how much rupees? 20,000. Understood, Tavani? What I taught you? The quantity decreased, the rate will also decrease. So it is in the same direction, so it is direct proportion. So direct proportion, what you will do? You will write as it is, cross multiplication, then cancellation, and you got the answer. Children, practice. Max needs practice. Okay? I think you have no doubt. I'll create questions in the Google form, upload it, practice it. Fine? And then what you will do? Take care of yourself. Bye.